A very good morning, students. Today we are going to start with another chapter, that is major landforms. Landforms are the natural shapes or features of the earth. Landforms include mountains, plateaus, plains, deserts and rivers. Now first is mountains. A mountain is a landform that rises high above its surrounding land. It is made of rocks and earth. Usually mountains are more than 900 meters above the mean sea level. Mountains varies in heights and in shapes. You can see mountains are varying in height and in shapes. Okay, they have steep slopes. These are steep slopes. So they have steep slopes and rounded and conical peaks. This is rounded and conical peaks. Okay, a group of mountains joined together is called a range or chain. The height and the shape of mountains tell their age. Young mountains like the Himalayas are high and have pointed peaks, and older mountains like the Aravallis have rounded peaks and are not so high. Another landform is plateaus. A plateau is a high land area with a flat top. It is also called a tableland. The surface of the plateau is often cut by rivers and streams. Some plateaus like the Deccan Plateau in India are large and extend to hundreds of kilometers. So some plateaus like the Plateau of Tibet are surrounded by mountain ranges from all sides. Next one is plains. Plains are a broad, flat and low-lying surface of land. Plains are also called lowlands. The land of a plain is mostly even. You can see the land is mostly even. Sometimes it may be slightly hilly. Most plains in the world are formed by the deposits of river. For example, the northern plains of India. The river deposits sand, mud and silt that they carry on their banks. So these deposits form plains. Plains are thickly populated as they are fertile because of the deposits by the rivers. The next is desert. Deserts are barren lands that receive very little rainfall. The region has an arid or a semi-arid climate. The days are hot and the nights are very cold. Sandstorms are commonly in all seasons. Sand dunes or hills of sand are its most common features. So most deserts have small area of water where plants grow and people live. So such a place is known as an oasis. The next is rivers. A river is a natural channel, usually of fresh water, that flows towards an ocean, a lake, sea or another river. A river usually starts high up in the mountains. As it flows, it carries rainwater, melted ice and snow from the mountains to the plains, lakes and sea. So majority of rivers flow into a larger water bodies like an ocean, sea or large lake. So the end of the river is called its mouth. Now we'll study about the journey of a river. Now in this picture you will see that river is having three stages. First stage, second stage and third stage. First stage is also known as the upper course. Second stage is known as the middle course. And third stage is known as the lower course. So majority of river originate from the mountains. And in this course the river has a very little water as it flows down the slopes. You can see it downs from the slopes and it gain speed and cuts a deep valley. Now see, because it flows down the slopes and it gains the speed and cuts a deep valley. And waterfall is one of the example of first stage, means upper course. Now next is a second stage, that is known as middle course. In this, the river enters the plains. As the river now flows on the flat surface, the speed lessens, means here the speed is fast, but now in this area the speed lessens. The river now meanders and forms loops. So an example of this course, river Ganga has this course between Kanpur and Allahabad. Now third stage is also known as lower course. Now in this, the river enters the a river joins a bigger water bodies like sea. The speed of the river is extremely slow and it divides into many channels. Thus this form a delta. A delta is a triangular shape and near the mouth of the river. An example of this course is river Ganga forms a delta as it flows into the Bay of Bengal. Now I hope the chapter major landforms are clear to everyone.